सत श्री अकाल स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर हेयर ऑन आर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑन इंटीग्रेशन. इट्स लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑन इंटीग्रेशन. इन दिस लेक्चर वी वुड बी डिस्कसिंग व्हाट इज दिस मीनिंग ऑफ इंटीग्रल. एंड देन वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ इंटीग्रल्स. We call them definite integral and indefinite integral. So what are these? How is this process of integration related to process of differentiation? What were the motivation behind differentiation and what is the motivation behind integration? Or you can say integral calculus. So let's try to grasp the ideas. When we talk about differential calculus, this was centered at the idea of derivative. Their limit played a very important role. So before the birth of calculus, this problem was not able to be answered by any mathematician. That is, suppose there is a ball which starts falling from the rest at some height. Initial velocity is zero. It starts falling. When it falls, this is a free fall. This fall can be, the distance traveled in this fall can be given as s is equal to 4.9 t square. Now we know that as the ball is falling down, its velocity is increasing. Let's say we want to find out the velocity exactly at 2 seconds. This was a problem. Now, the normal formula we have to find the velocity is till 9th or 10th standard we used to study, v is equal to displacement by time. Then we understood that what is this actually. We gave it a form of v is equal to delta s by delta t. So if the question would have been, what is the velocity of the ball in t2 is equal to 2 seconds, and here the start of fall t1 was 0 seconds. In this time interval delta t of 2 seconds, what was the velocity? We could have easily put the value of t is equal to 2 and find the distance traveled at 2 seconds. That would have been 4.9 into 2 into 2 is 4. That is equal to 19.6 meter. So the displacement in delta t 2 seconds is 19.6 meters. The velocity I could have calculated was 9.8 meter per second. On close observation, we find that this is not the velocity at 2 seconds. Rather, this velocity we have found is the average velocity in this interval. So I added the word average in 10 plus 1 class, 11th class. I understood this is average velocity, but my question was not this. The question was, what is the velocity at 2 seconds? Means instantaneous velocity was being asked. When we want to find the instantaneous velocity by this formula, delta s by delta t, when I pertinently ask, what is the velocity at 2 seconds? What is the time interval? Any student can answer. When I ask somebody, what is the velocity at 2 seconds? I'm not talking about interval. then the interval is, any student? 0 seconds. And in this delta t, what was the distance traveled by the ball? When delta t is 0 second, time interval is 0 second, what is distance traveled in 0 second? 0 meter. So I was like, I cannot say anything. I'm not able to find instantaneous velocity by this formula, because my delta s is 0, my delta t is also 0. I'm not being given any interval. In no interval, no distance is traveled, I am not able to find instantaneous velocity at 2 seconds. Then came the concept of limit, right? I got negative left hand side limit, right hand side limit. From this, I defined the derivative of the function. The derivative of the function, let's say this s is equal to 4.9 t square. I could have taken as f of x is equal to 4.9 x square. Then the derivative of this function f of x, I define as limit h approaches 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. This concept gave me the, when I put the value of x as 2 seconds, instantaneous velocity. So this was the birth of calculus. So we call it differential calculus. The reverse of this is integral calculus. So what is the reverse of this? That means if at different intervals some function is given, or the derivative, at different point of time, in this case especially, if the instantaneous velocity is given, let's say at 1 second, 1.1 second, 1.2 second, 2 second, 2.5 second, all instantaneous velocity is given, and my motivation is to find out this function. Integration exactly does this. Differentiation helps me to find instantaneous stuff. Integration helps me to find function if the derivative of the function is given. Remember, students, when derivative of the function is given, this derivative f dash x, this can also be defined as d dx of f of x. When the derivative of the function is defined, integration can help me to find out what? It can help me to find out the function, the reverse process. From the function, we found instantaneous stuff using differential calculus. From the instantaneous stuff, we want to find out the function, that is integral calculus. Let's discuss in detail. Okay, 1 second. Yes, students. So in a nutshell, I can say the differential calculus was centered at the concept of derivative, dy by dx. Let's say y is equal to f of x, some function. The motivation in this differential calculus was to find the tangent lines. Now I'm talking in terms of geometry. Tangent lines, let's say this was the function. I want to find out the derivative of the function at this point. Let's say this function is same, s is equal to 4.9 t square. My question is, what will be the velocity at 2 seconds? So I came to know that's easily given by the slope of the curve at this point. Now, this is the tangent. This line is tangent to the curve. So once we know the tangent, then finding out its slope, we know that slope of a line is equal to tan theta, the angle it makes with the positive x-axis. So once you find the slope, you know, we will get the answer of instantaneous velocity at this point, right? Okay. Integration as such, this process is reverse of differentiation. In integration, what are my aims? What is my motivation? What is my aim? I want to find, most importantly, I want to find the function. In which case, when derivative is given. Number two, the most interesting application of integration is, students, let's say you have been given some function. This is some function, y is equal to f of x, right? Now, it's been asked to find out the area under this curve, or you can say whatever is the curve of the function. This is the curve of the function. What is the area under this curve? This application was really great, and this application really helped me to find the surface area of irregular objects also, including the surface area of sphere and other objects, 3D objects. Suppose I take this curve, y is equal to f of x. Integration helped me to find out this area. Okay. Now, on the other hand, from this, I can easily define what is the meaning of definite integrals and indefinite integrals. But before this, let me define what is a integral. So, see, students, now we all know the derivative of sine x is, anybody, any student, what is the derivative of sine x, ddx of sine x?
Minus cos x.
No, it's not minus cos x.
It's cos x.
Right? Now, in this condition, you see the derivative of this function. What is the function? Sine x is given. Right? Derivative of sine x is given. In the second case, derivative of, let's say, x cubed by 3. Is given. This will be equal to, you know that 1 by 3 would be out. So this would be 3 into x squared by the formula. You remember ddx of x raised to power n is equal to any student n x raised to power
x raised to power n minus 1
n minus 1. That's perfectly right. Good. Again, this formula, I know this is equal to x squared. Third one, I may take ddx of e raised to power x. This is an exponential function. Anyone remembers? This is equal to
e raised to power x.
Good. Now, see, in all these three cases, students, what is given? The differentiation, the derivative, these are differentiation processes. The derivative of a function is given. Derivative of sine x is cos x. Derivative of x cubed by 3 is this and this. Now, I can do the reverse. Means, derivative of sine x is given. I may write integral cos x. Derivative of this dx is equal to the function. See what I discussed 2 minutes back. The main aim or the motivation behind the process of integration is, what is this? Finding a function when derivative is given. So you see, students, here the derivative of sine x is given. What does the integral helps me? Integral cos x dx helps me to find out the function, and the function is sine x. But along with this function will come a constant c. This is known as constant of integration. Now, students, what is this constant of integration? This constant of integration, I'll write here. Constant of integration is an arbitrary constant. It's an arbitrary constant by varying which, if I vary this, if I change this, by varying which we get different antiderivatives. We get different antiderivatives. Antiderivative means integral. Of a given function. Of a given function. Right? So it has importance, but its importance reduces to zero when I talk about definite integral. Right? It gets cancelled. So similarly, students, I can apply the same thing here and here. Okay? So these are the two motivations behind integration. And suppose, students, I'm having a function, let's say this, y is equal to f of x, right? If I talk about a area bounded by lower boundary and upper boundary, means let's say this is A and this is B point. I'm talking about a specific area. I'm only talking about this area where the complete area of the function can be infinity or maybe more. I don't know. But if you talk about just this area, this comes under the purview of definite integral. So I would name it like integral A to B. And here it would be simply integral without lower and upper boundary, right? Means if this is not there and I just want to find the integration of the function, I want to get the function, I want to find the integral, without specifying the lower and upper limit. It is indefinite interval. Students, you understood the difference between definite integral and indefinite integral?
Yes, sir.
That's good. So when we are limiting the process of integration between two limits, we talk about definite integral. And if there is no limits, we're generally talking without defining lower and upper boundary, it comes under the purview of indefinite integral. So students, now we go ahead and see how we can find the different functions in the integration. So here we can generally write, let's say if f dash x, this symbolizes the derivative, is equal to f of x, then we can say integral of f of x dx is equal to f of x plus c, right? Whatever I have said before, I'm just writing it mathematically, right? Symbolizing that the process of integration is reverse of process of differentiation, right? Now see students, you know these derivatives corresponding to these derivatives, we are going to define the integrals, or we call them antiderivatives. Integrals, or we call them antiderivatives. Okay. So we know that ddx of x raised to power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 would be equal to x raised to power n. See how it comes? N plus 1 will be out. This will be n plus 1 minus n plus 1 into x raised to power n plus 1 minus 1. So n plus 1 will cancel with n plus 1. You get x raised to power n. Now, how do you define integral? Integral x raised to power n. Integral of this would be equal to the function. This was the basic function. What is the function? X raised to power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 along with the, what is this? Constant of integration c, right? Here we must remember n is never equal to, and is not equal to minus 1. Otherwise, you know, it becomes not defined. Similarly, students, what is derivative of x? What is ddx of x? Any student?
One.
Now, we go the reverse side. Can you speak? You can speak with me. Integral of one. Dx would be equal to the function. What was the function? X. Right? But with constant of?
Constants.
We can also write it simply, need not write 1 integral dx is equal to x plus
x.
Similarly, students, now try to speak out so your fear will be removed. Now you know that ddx of sine x, don't make the mistake of minus, is equal to
cos x.
So can you define the integral?
Integral
cos x,
dx is equal to sine x plus c.
Helping us to finding out the function. Let me go back and again tell this. What was the basic motivation behind integration process? It helps in finding the function when, please read this, derivative is given.
Given.
All these cases, students, derivative is given. We are taking help of integration to find out the function jiska derivative diya hua hai. So integral cos x dx would be equal to, come on, sin
x plus c.
Constant of integration must come. Similarly, students, ddx of, come on, minus cos x is equal to sin x. So speak integral
sin x dx is equal to minus cos x plus c.
Beautiful. That's good. I'm happy. So let's do more. Ddx of, come on, tan x is equal to secant square x. Now, how will you do? Integral of
secant square x dx is equal to tan x plus c.
Beautiful. Tan x plus c. Simran, I will be happy you also speak. Ddx of minus cot x would be equal to cosecant square x. Yes, Rupinder Kaur. Integral
of cosecant square x is equal to, yes, minus cot x plus c.
Tension is very important. Dx is equal to
minus cot x plus c.
That's constant of integration. Beautiful. Keep going. Dx of secant x is equal to secant x tan x.
Tan x.
What? Integral.
Secant x tan x dx is equal to secant x plus constant.
So in all these cases, what we are doing, can you say? You can say, sir, when the derivative of a function is given, say that,
when the derivative of function is given,
integration process helps us to find out the function. Say, integration process helps us
integration process helps us to find out the function.
Keda function? O function jeda derivative, right?
Given.
Yes, jeda derivative given hai, and the derivative was secant x tan x. So we use the derivative to find out the function. What was the function? Secant x. Let's go further. Now, ddx of, then you should write minus cosecant x yourself. Now I'll do a little more speed. Sine inverse x is equal to, do you remember? 1 divided by 1
minus sine x squared.
So integral of, come on, integral dx. 1 minus x
squared, is equal to sine inverse x
plus c.
Beautiful. Plus c.
Similarly, ddx minus cos inverse x is also is equal to sine. So I can say integral minus cos inverse. I'm sorry. I made a mistake here. I want to find out the function, not the derivative. Integral, same, dx divided by 1 minus x square under root would also be equal to minus cos inverse x plus c. Beautiful. Next, we have number tan inverse x is equal to 1 plus x square. Yes, Rupinder Kaur, please speak. Integral
dx by 1 plus x square.
Beautiful. 1 plus x
is equal to tan inverse x
plus
constant.
Yeah. So do it for the. So this will also be equal to minus cot inverse x plus c. Am I right? Similarly, we can ddx of secant inverse x students is equal to 1 by x into x square minus 1. These are all outputs for differentiation process, right? So we can write integral, come on, 1 by x into x square minus
integral, 1. Sir, integral dx by x square, x under root x square minus 1 is equal to secant inverse x plus constant.
Would also be equal to, can you say, minus cosecant
inverse x plus,
because dx of minus cosecant inverse x is also the same thing, right? Then ddx of exponential function, you know this is same, e raised to power x. So please find the integral. Integral
e raised to power x dx is
equal to
e raised to power x plus constant.
Plus constant. So that's good. Then we can do the last one. Ddx of log mod x, we take positive value of x, is equal to 1 by x. So we can, we normally use this formula a lot. Integral 1 by x dx or dx by x would be equal to log mod
x plus c.
Students, this was the first lecture. Lot more videos to come. So we appeal to you to give us a chance to be connected to you. Do subscribe, learn CBSE, watch more videos. Education and knowledge must expand. So share with your friends. Thank you very much. Hope to see you with your comments with the second video. Bye.